Everyone in the business world needs to work with contracts. And today we're going to look into how to quickly create business contracts with the help of Make No-Code Automation. You're going to learn how to easily set up a database that you use as the base for your contracts. You set up contract template and even send it directly as a PDF. And then also some optional ways of for additional signing at the very end that I will want to show you in this video. My name is Manuel and I'm the founder of Techflow.ai and we love automation. I'll be demonstrating a lease or rent contract, and this Google Sheet is highly dynamic, so it's super customizable and you can add all dynamic elements that you want to have in your contract, and then each row will contain all the elements that are necessary for one contract to be created. What I'm showing right now includes the basic elements that we are going to need for the automation. All right, let's get started with the foundation. First, we will have a simple database that contains the full name, the email address, and the rent amount for a specific room that we want to send a contract for, the start date and the end date of the contract that we want to set up, and then some status metrics like are the details ready. If we change it to yes, then we'll be picked up by our automation and actually send out the contract, and then the rest will be filled out by our automation. So a team member can fill out this, or another automation can fill out this information, maybe based on a form, and then it can be approved by someone, and once it's approved, then you send it off for a signature to that specific person. All right, let's look into how the document is set up. First, the contract itself. We are using a Google Doc template for this. So simply set up a new Google document and create your whole contract, put everything in there that you need to have in there, and use curly braces for anything that you want to have dynamic. For example, the room number, the start date of the contract, the end date of the contract, then like the amount that it costs for this one, then anything else, again the amount, then anything else that is dynamic, you want to use the curly braces around it, and then the date created and also the name of the new tenant, right? So this should match the values that you have here because you're going to use them to fill up the fields dynamically. All right, let's jump into Make to see how it actually works. First, we are searching the Google Sheet that I've just shown you and checking for specific filters. If the details ready column is set to yes, so that means it has been approved or all the details are there, we can start creating the contract. And if the contract created is not equal to created, so if it's not yet there, you can also say if that's empty, then if it does not exist, then you want to create the contract. We can set it for testing purposes to a number of returned rows to 1. And then once it's fully working, you can remove the limit and then it would create all contracts that are ready to be created at once. Now, the next thing is creating a document from a template Google Docs module. This one allows you to have the values set up here like this for the curly braces that you prepared already. And here it will allow you to map the room number, the full name, the start date and the end date, the amount and the date that this has been given out via this mapping. So it can come from your Google Sheet data that you have retrieved, and you can also give it a dynamic title, for example with a room number and the full name agreement, and then you store it in your Google Drive. You can define the folder ID here and then we'll upload it straight away into your folder. Then next step would be an RN. We would convert docs to PDF because we want to have a PDF version that you can't change. Obviously, you can't sign a Google document and we need a PDF version. So it's very simple. You just put in document ID and you select the type that you want to have as an output in the download document module. And then we send the contract agreement to the client right away with an email. So you can also map the values dynamically from your Google Sheet at the full name there and then like greet them and put any content in there to say, okay, attach it to this contract. You'll find the agreement document. Please review it, sign it, and send it back to me at your earliest convenience. And then here down there, you can select an attachment file and simply select the Google Docs download a document as input. And that will attach the newly generated PDF or document with all the dynamic values being filled out to this email. And then lastly, we want to update our Google Sheet to know, okay, this contract has been created. Let's review. The contract has been created. The email has been sent. Yes, the date created and the contract URL. We want to include that in our Google Sheet, and we're doing it by updating that specific row at the very end of our automation. This is a very common concept that we use quite often to have like some sort of status columns that we use in the filter in the search roles module at the very beginning. So for example, here, details ready and contract created is not created yet, and only then we process it. And in the end, we update this row so it does not match this filter again and it's not being processed again. Because of course, we don't want to create the same contract multiple times and send it to the same tenant multiple times. And that's what these status columns are for. So that's very important and a concept that you should use as well, like updating the row once you're done with all the details that are relevant for any future processes or to simply filter out this condition at the very beginning. All right, let's let it run once and see how it works. Also, one very important thing is that you always want to put a filter after search rows module if row number exists. Why? Because otherwise, your scenario will simply proceed with the following modules, which will not have the proper fields being mapped and the email will not work and everything will fail just because this filter is not set up. Because the search rows module, even if it does not find any results, it will continue. Even if total numbers of bundles is zero, it will try to continue throughout the rest of the scenario, but of course, it will not be able to process it. That means this filter is very crucial, it's very important, and you should always add that into after a search roles module if you don't want the scenario to continue and be executed, of course. Otherwise, as a workaround, you can also add a router and then specify, okay, in case no row was found, I actually want to do XYZ. So row found, and then you add another path, and then you do whatever you want afterwards. But I won't do this for now for this demonstration purposes, so I will just keep it like this. And now if I run this once, there's actually no row found because our filter condition do not match. Let's check again. We have details already, yes, and contract created is not equal to created. So we don't have any column or any row where details ready is already set to yes. So let's update that one and say, okay, yes, it's here. And then let's try again to see if it processes our template now. Yes, row was found. So it found the row with ID number 8 for Sarah Miller and all these details, and it's sending it to my email address. And then we create the document, we download the document, and we update our Google Sheet at the very end. So over here, it updated the row with created, email sent, yes, the date that it was created. And then also we have the final document here for Sarah Miller, which looks like this. We have the tenant, we have the room number, we have the beginning date, the start date and the end date. The amount is here, the amount is also there. So you can just format your template in a way that with the parameters here, if you format them, they will keep that format and will just replace the value that it actually has. And then also the tenant name, Sarah Miller down there, and the date created and so on. All right, now let's check that email. Here's the email received. Congratulations. Here's your tenant agreement, Sarah Miller. I hope this email finds you well, blah, 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 blah. And then everything attached. And down here, we have the actual PDF document that is ready to be downloaded, signed, and then sent back to the person. So it's definitely a PDF with everything being dynamic. Now, that is actually how you can create business contracts very quickly. Just create a template, fill out all the values dynamically from any source. This can be directly a forum, it can be a Google Sheet, or it can be any other database that you want to use. And now at the very end, of course, you don't have to send it as a PDF version directly to the client for signing. It would also be convenient if you're creating a document for digital signature. And there are a bunch of tools out there that you can use. For example, if you just search for Sign, there is the tool called Sign, there is called Sign Now, ForeSign, SapSign, HiSign, DigiSign, DocuSign, and a lot of others that you can actually use for digital signature. And most of them allow you to, like Dropbox Sign is formerly known as HelloSign, and most of them allow you to upload a document. You can specify the field location with parameters. Like you can specify the field location with the coordinates of that field. You have tried and error a little bit at the beginning to say, okay, the signature field is exactly on the last page, these X and Y coordinates, and there it should be located. And also the date signed should be at these coordinates. And then you set it up once for a template, and then you simply create the document, you upload the PDF automatically with Make straight over here, and send the digital ready document to the client. And then they don't have to print it out and sign it, because we're living in 2024, it would be, I don't know. You should not do that anymore, right? So that being said, you can get a full blueprint of this scenario. If you want to, just go to the description below this video, and there you will find a link to the blueprint, and you can download it for yourself, and then you can just play around with it. You can adapt it to yourself, and we will also include this tenant agreement template, so you can also play around with that one. All right, so I hope this was helpful, and stay tuned for more. Thank you very much for watching.